A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 29th August, on the front page you have age of third degree torture over, Shah tells police officials. So this is regarding the Home Ministry. So Home Ministry controls the police. It is the administrative ministry for police and law and order, and it has asked police officials to set up a robust forensic setup. So the third degree torture and extracting evidence or confession from the criminals is not the way ahead, but forensic evidence investigation has to be bettered, and along those lines steps are being taken. Then this is 5-judge Supreme Court bench to hear pleas on withdrawal of Article 370. So Article 370 of the Constitution, which provided special status to Jammu and Kashmir, has been withdrawn, and Jammu and Kashmir has been bifurcated into two union territories. So Supreme Court has had a petition filed, and this 5-judge bench of the Supreme Court is going to hear petitions on this. So the order as such is coming amid caution by government to exercise restraint on observations on Jammu and Kashmir. So government has asked the Supreme Court to exercise restraint on observations on Jammu and Kashmir. Then this is cabinet eases rules for FDI in retail media. So Union Cabinet has announced number of decisions, to attract FDI, and this includes local sourcing norms for single brand retail companies. And here you can see the local sourcing norms which are there are now being eased. So local sourcing was when FDI comes in retail in the country, they should source locally. 30% of its goods should be sourced from within India by 51% FDI. So this has been eased now. New decision says that this 30% can be calculated over the first 5 years of operation. Then below you have Johnson suspends Parliament till October 14. So this is regarding British Prime Minister Boris Johnson. He has announced that the British Parliament suspension would be extended until October 14. That is just 2 weeks before the UK is set to leave the European Union. So this has sparked outrage among anti-Brexit MPs. Then on page 9 you have new rupees 9.3 crore study to check antibiotic resistance in Ganga. So this is a project which is expected to last 2 years, and it will identify sources of E. coli bacteria. So the 2,500 kilometer long river, its stretches would be checked to see if the river contains microbes that may promote antibiotic resistance, because it's a serious cause of concern. Even in 2014, you can see researchers from UK and IIT Delhi sampled water and sediments at 7 sites along Ganga in different seasons. And they reported that the level of resistance genes that lead to superbugs were about 60 times greater during pilgrimage months of May and June than at other times of the year. Then here you have Chandrayaan 2 nears moon. So the third orbit maneuver is taking place, and the gap is being narrowed now. So Chandrayaan 2 is moving near the moon. We know that it is on September 7 that the landing would take place. So that is awaited. On the editorial page, the first editorial is message delivered. So this is regarding the G7 summit. It says not everything went right at the G7 summit, but PM Modi got the ear of President Trump. So we saw yesterday also on front page news how Prime Minister Narendra Modi clearly stated that there is no scope of third party mediation in Jammu and Kashmir. So the message has been clearly delivered is what this article, what this editorial speaks of. Then next is murder most foul. So this is regarding honor killing. So it says India needs a comprehensive law to deal with honor killing. So it is considered as a class of murder, but it's murder that family members commit while seeking to impose on young couples their medieval views that all marriages should be within their community. Then the lead article, hardly the brick and mortar of a revival. So this is regarding the transfer of RBI surplus. So this article criticizes how this is only a stopgap measure which will not address the key problem of a lack of demand. That is it. And this is Kashmir's information vacuum. So this is regarding how legislative backing is being appropriated to normalize communication shutdowns. So communication being shut down and for so long is a serious cause of concern. Fundamental rights are being suspended. So this is there. Then on the op-ed page, you have democracy and its discontents. So it says India must strengthen institutions that lie between public sphere and formal government institutions. So democracy needs to be strengthened through more participation from the people in governance through institutions that lie in between in the public sphere. So it talks about how discontent has to be raised, democracy has to be strengthened. Then this is in Tamil Nadu, making power while the sun shines. So this article says that the state government of Tamil Nadu needs a fair tariff setting process for solar power. So Tamil Nadu has released its solar energy policy in 2012 and has introduced net metering also, net metering mechanism for rooftop solar panels. Means if solar energy generated is more than it would be brought, means the power discoms, distribution companies would buy that solar energy from the household and they would be selling off further. So that would bring in a cut in the meter of the household from whom who have generated more of solar energy than their usage. So that is called net metering. Then below you have public health versus free speech. So this is regarding tobacco companies, how they're trying their best to prevent pictorial warnings on cigarette packages in US. So we have this in India and many countries have adopted this, but in USA there's strong resistance to such an initiative. Then on international page you have UK opposition condemns Boris move. So we saw on the front page Boris Johnson, the British Prime Minister, has extended the parliament suspension. So it is called a smash and grab on democracy to force through a no deal exit. So this is what the opposition leader also says. And this is one country, two systems and many problems. So this is regarding Hong Kong. With Hong Kong in disarray, it is said China's policy is back in focus, that is one country, two systems policy. And then you have Facebook tightens rules for political ads in US. So Facebook has tightened its rules for political ads ahead of the 2020 US elections. So it will require more information about who is paying for campaign messages. On business page you have Nod for sugar export subsidy. So cabinet has okayed offer of 10.45 rupees per kg to incentivize mills to export surplus stock. So sugar, excess sugar was a cause of concern. So now the government has allowed export with a subsidy. So if you are exporting, there will be a subsidy. Then this is producers welcome decision. So WTO compliance subsidy will aid shipping of 6 million tons of sugar. So it is called a WTO compliant initiative. And below you have Forex gains OMOs, open market operations, aid RBI's record surplus. So the large transfer from RBI to the union government is likely to be a one-time event. But how did this huge surplus come forth is a question for which the answer is given here. Then on the last page you have Star Tortoise otters get higher protection at CITES. So CITES is Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species on Wild Flora and Fauna. So CITES has given higher protection to star tortoise and the otters. So a complete international ban will be enforced on their trade as part of efforts to boost their numbers. So this is there. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.